everyone, welcome to the channel. My name is Amy and I have two extra ribs. So when I was writing down video ideas for this channel, this certainly wasn't on it. This is a very new discovery, but I thought it was too crazy not to make a video about. I've actually just filmed some little learners videos, which is why I'm in the yellow chair, but I grabbed my blanket so we can be cozy, because we like to be cozy on this channel and a bit more informal. So as many of you know, I have lots of different medical conditions and they cause me a lot of pain, especially one called Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, which causes a lot of pain in my muscles and joints. And so I am often going for physiotherapy, and I just went back because I've been having a lot of trouble with my neck and back. I do have a bulging disc in my neck, but that didn't seem to be the thing that was causing these problems. So my GP ordered an x-ray of my neck just to check that there wasn't kind of some kind of infection or I guess arthritis or something, and she told me it was all fine, nothing came up. So I went to see my physiotherapist and she looked at my x-ray and she said, well, your x-ray did show something actually. It shows you have two extra ribs. I think when she said that to me, I said, I'm sorry, what? And I have a really good relationship with my physiotherapist, so she just kind of laughed a little bit and said, yes, you have two cervical ribs. And I said, well, the GP told me nothing abnormal came up. And she said, well, it's not totally abnormal because you could have them and they don't cause any problems, but I think it's probably worth you knowing about them. So let me explain what they are, because obviously I had to go and research all of this. Now, when I've been researching it, the kind of numbers are a little bit different depending on where you look, but it seems to be that about 1 in 200 people to 1 in 100 people have a cervical rib. So it's about 0.5% to 1% of the population have a cervical rib, an extra rib. Even less within that have two cervical ribs, and I guess I'm just the lucky one who got two of them. So they're cervical ribs. Your cervical spine is kind of your neck. I am not a doctor or anything, so, you know, take everything I say with a pinch of salt. So you have your cervical spine, which is kind of your neck, and so your cervical ribs are attached to your top rib and one of the vertebrae in your neck, in your cervical spine. I'm going to show you some x-rays of cervical ribs. They're not my x-rays because who knows how long it'll take to actually get a copy of my own x-rays, but this is what cervical ribs look like. So you have your normal first rib, your top rib, and then if you have a cervical rib, there's another one coming off of your top rib and connecting to your neck a bit higher up. And it depends on what kind of cervical rib you have, whether or not it is a fully formed bone, a fully formed rib, or it can just be kind of a thinner strand of tissues and fibres there. As far as I'm aware, mine are both bones. I don't know if any of you would have read the book The Power. I'm sure many of you have because it's a super popular book. In that book, and this is not a big spoiler or anything, but if you don't want to hear what I'm about to say, then just go to the timestamp down below. In that book, women have an organ called, I think it's called the skein or the skein, and it's just up here, kind of where my cervical ribs would be, and it gives them special powers. So I'm thinking now that if I've got these two extra ribs, I must have some superpowers, right? Because otherwise, why would I have them? Why bother? I looked up where these come from because I was wondering, you know, am I a mutation or is this kind of like some evolutionary throwback? Am I evolving into a new human or is this something from way back when? And it was a little bit tricky to find, but it seems like it's a throwback. So I'm not a superhuman yet. Cervical ribs are congenital, which means that they are present from birth. You don't like grow them when you're 25. They are there from when you're born. And some people who have them, who have one or two, can just go through life never knowing, never really having an issue because they don't bother them, and that's fine. Other people can develop something called thoracic outlet syndrome. It usually starts between the ages of 20 and 50, and as I just turned 30, I guess it was my turn. So with thoracic outlet syndrome, it's all about how the, again, not a doctor, nerves are kind of compressed by the cervical rib, because obviously that rib isn't really supposed to be there. So the way that the nerves are going, it's all kind of being compressed. So this can cause neck pain, shoulder pain, pins and needles, or numbness, loss of feeling in areas of your arm or your fingers. Sometimes this means that you can't do kind of fine motor activities like using a pencil or doing up buttons. You can also get swelling in the arm that's affected, but that's very rare. Obviously, I have cervical ribs on both sides. Don't know if I've got thoracic outlet syndrome on both sides, but it seems likely. Also, just want to pause here to say that I haven't officially been diagnosed with thoracic outlet syndrome. My physiotherapist just thinks that's what I have, and as it was our first appointment, we'll get into it more the next time. But we know I definitely have two cervical ribs, two extra ribs, and lots of neck, arm, and finger issues. It can cause Raynaud's phenomenon, which I hope I'm saying that right, which is where the blood supply to the ends of the fingers isn't great and they turn white and they're really cold. I think that also happens in your toes, but I don't know if thoracic outlet syndrome would affect your toes because it's the nerves aren't connected. I'm not a doctor, but anyway. The other thing that can happen is that as well as your nerves being compressed, your subclavian artery can also be affected. This means that it could be compressed or a blood clot could form there, which is obviously a bigger issue. As far as I'm aware, I don't have any symptoms of that, so just the nerves for now. It seems to be that when it comes to treatment, physiotherapy and massage to kind of strengthen the muscles around there and kind of correcting your posture, I definitely have poor posture, can help. But it doesn't seem like we can really stop any of it from happening completely. But if the cervical rib is causing a lot of problems, then you can have surgery to have it removed. I think that's more when it's affecting your artery, and obviously that is a huge problem. Or maybe when people, you know, really lose their feeling a lot and aren't able to use their arms properly. Again, not a doctor. But I do watch a lot of medical shows, so I kind of feel like I've got a sofa degree in medicine. So yes, that's my story about how I found out that I have two extra ribs. Do you have an extra rib? Please let me know in the comments below. It would be great to meet someone else who has this really weird thing going on in their skeleton, on their skeleton. I guess it's part of my skeleton. Anyway, I'm going to stop talking now. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please give it a like if you found it interesting or wild or crazy or funny. And don't forget to subscribe so that you can see more videos. Probably not like this because I don't intend on having any extra bones, but you never know. But please do subscribe so that you can see my future videos. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.